Guys, I want you to tell me this, right? What do you say and what's your thought about Jacob Zuma, right? So it has been reported that Jacob Zuma or look, King Mswati was there to say, "Hi, I'm going to lobola your girl, your what?" And then Jacob Zuma went there listening to those people telling how you want to marry your 21-year girl. And Jacob Zuma was like, as in, Jacob Zuma stood up with his VIP, look, VIP team and walk away, and then he left them like that. So now, so that the look, there's that article that it came out by Sunday World. It was written by Usandile Mota and Mzilikazi wa Africa. Well, so yeah, in that article, the heading of the article says, Zuma storm out of Mswati lobola talks for his daughter Nomcebo. Oh, Nomcebo, my daughter, fellow what to Zuma and many man. Leave it, former President Jacob Zuma stormed out. In other words, he left the meeting out of lobola negotiations where a delegation of a certain royal came to ask for his 21-year-old daughter as hand into marriage on behalf of his 56-year-old friend, King Mswati III. Now, can the king really come to the point of realization that, hi, no, it is enough now. 56 versus 21. Ah, let me check the age gap there. I can't, guys. Yeah. 56 versus 21. Hey, let me check. I want to check the age gap there. Oh, the age gap is 35 years. Pella, guys, other people impregnate at the age of 18, 19. So if you check Mswati, it's possible that he could have a child at the age of 21, 22. So you notice that if he had a child at the age of 21, so that child will be equal to the age of the baby that is marrying. But again, other people were saying, I can pay no Jacob Zuma now la con weabo. Weabo manje eh. But God will not hold no gay. But when Jacob Zuma was 50 something to 60, Latongo was 40 or something, Latongo was being born. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, it's those things, you know. I don't know. Will you say that it's karma for former President Jacob Zuma? Let's remove emotions aside in this one. Will you say, yo, Jacob Zuma is facing karma because of Latongo? What's your take? Get into the comment section, please. But wait, before you go, Oibo, why will you go? You need to do this.
If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the super thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, we'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment, so the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, so the article says, Jacob Zuma said, somebody that was speaking to Sunday World says, I've never seen Unqamalala Zuma losing it like that. He tried to hide it, but you could tell that he was angry. The question is, why was he angry? Was he angry because 21-year-old is going to be married to 56-year-old? What was he angry? Was he angry because the person who's doing this is a friend to him? What was he angry about? Let's read this. He just stood up and said, say, Utini, say your sala, oh,
Senyo salanqhubeka bafana bakithi, and he likes that bafana bakithi. Wenzo use. You know what we're talking about. Musi mayima. Musi mayima. Why? He just stood up and say, I won't be part of this. You will have to carry on without me, my brother. He then left, leaving all of us shocked. An insider speaking on condition of anonymity revealed to a Sunday World this week. Mina, I want to know, Uguti, will you consider this a karma? Because like Tongo, at some point, she was trying to play a victim into this. You remember not long ago, that Tongo was busy telling us the age. I was a virgin. I was this. Now, when you read deep down in those messages, like Tongo was trying to play a victim there to say, I was young. Maybe somehow Latongo was saying, Jacob Zuma took advantage of me. That's how she sounded. You know, when I was listening to what she was saying, I'm like, Latongo, what are you saying, basically? Well, Latongo tinda. So, I don't know. You'll have to tell me in the comment section below, because this is a very tricky thing. But again, the newspaper continues to say, the Eswatini delegation accompanied by AmaZulu, AmaZulu King, Mrs. Zulu, Gazwelitini spokesperson, Princess Lokosimpiwe Zulu, together with commander of the Amabuto regiment, had been dispatched to perform the Ugutela custom, which entails making the prospective groom intentions to the woman's family, right? Chief Makwakwa Kametse and His Majesty Chief Executive Officer Prince Hlangabeza Dlamini and the Tuka Skome Skombeni Dlamini, the King's Amisuri led King Mswati's delegation. When we spoke about it the first time, some people said we were lying. Manje nthini ke naku kunje Nomcebo being married by a 56 year old. Now I'm gonna tell you where my problem is with this thing, right? My problem is the fact that, you know, for now it looks glammy, it looks funny, it looks what. But this, I'm not saying that they are doing it. But I'm gonna tell you a story that is in the Bible, and you will understand how it relates to this. Now, there was a man in the Bible called David. When David was aging, the people still needed David, you know, but David was aging. So what they did, they went and they found a young lady to come and sleep with David. So in other words, he had a side chick that was very young, very, very young. And the intention there was to revive David. So when you first got the concept from the biblical perspective of older people sleeping with younger people, it has always been associated with reviving younger people. It has always been believed that a young blood, a flesh blood revives an older person. You know what I'm saying? So maybe it can also, maybe that also explains the concept of Bentham, because others will just think, It's just people desperate for what. No, to some people, it's actually, there's more explanation to that rather than what you are thinking. So I am saying, in a world where we are exposed to such knowledge, now that there's a young kid, really fairly fresh from, this person probably hasn't even finished varsity. If they did, okay, it can happen because they are from Zuma family, obviously. They finished school at the age of 17, 18. They started university. But just imagine 18, 19, 20, 21. At age 21, they are probably finishing varsity. They are not even done with their schooling. But now they are going to marry a well-matured person. Worst part, a person who's in charge of a whole country. a dignitary to be specific. Hey, I don't think, man, it's a good idea for me. Just looking at the age, man, the age-wise, nothing else, but the age-wise, for me, I don't think it's a good idea.